On Stardate 48315.6, the USS Voyager was transported beyond our control, 70,000 light-years across the galaxy to the Delta Quadrant. There, without aid from Starfleet, we began our 70-year journey home. In our numerous encounters, we came into contact with many dangerous and violent species. Having a limited crew with no chance of reinforcements, we determined that we needed a specialized team to handle the more dangerous situations. Tuvok, Voyager's chief of security, assembled an elite force of security personnel named the Hazard Team. Ensign Monroe is second in command of this uniquely trained team. Equipped with Seven of Nine's experimental anti-Borg weapon, the Infinity Modulator, the Hazard Team has beamed to a Borg cube on a dangerous mission. However, the team was quickly overwhelmed, and the I-Mod is now in the hands of the Borg. Separated from the rest, Monroe is attempting to rescue the team.
Thank you. my savior. Get the Imon. It's on that table. Monroe, let's go.
Get Odell back to the ship.
Back in 5 minutes, I'm not going in after you.
Austin.
Sir, I was hit. The Borg took the team. We're there.
Beam out, Chang. You've done all you can.
Aye, sir.
Thank you.
They're trapped.
Acknowledged it. See if you can locate the control console for the force field.
Nice going, Monroe.
Sir, if I may, how was I supposed to know the panel would explode?
That point is not relevant, Ms. Monroe. A given situation is not as predictable as you might desire. Your reckless decision has caused the death of you and your teammates. You have failed. Had you followed standard hazard team procedures, you may have survived the simulation and achieved your mission objectives.
Yes, sir. Procedure.
Speak freely, Ensign. Deck 4.
With all due respect, sir, I don't think procedure would have mattered. There wasn't any way I could have possibly rescued them.
Someday, Ms. Monroe, you may be called upon to do the impossible. Consider this to be your personal Kobayashi Maru.
Red alert. All hands to battle stations.
Computer, reroute turbo lift to the bridge.
Status.
Captain, we have reports of secondary EPS conduits on decks 8 and 9 rupturing.
Warp drive is offline.
What happened?
We responded to a distress signal from a derelict vessel and it opened fire.
Tuvok, they don't respond to hails. Maybe we need to send a clearer message. Target their weapon systems and disable them.
Firing phasers. Direct hit. Phasers had no discernible effect. Aft shields are down, Captain. Rerouting auxiliary power to the shields.
Captain, I'm getting reports of extensive damage on decks 9 and 10. We're not going to survive another hit.
Photon torpedoes, full spread.
Torpedoes away.
Space. I think we've been pulled through some sort of isodimensional rift.
Where are we?
Apparently, here, Captain. Sensors and most of Voyager's primary systems are offline. Until repairs are made, it may be difficult to ascertain exactly where here is.
Thank you.
Captain's log, stardate 53854.7. Voyager was attacked by an unknown force and transported to some kind of starship graveyard, whereabouts unknown. The ship is heavily damaged. Communications, propulsion, and other systems are offline. Until repairs are done, we're utterly helpless. Stranded. Let's get this ship back together, Chakotay. Get damage control online. Harry, find out what you can about those other ships, and exactly where we are.
Aye, Captain.
Captain, there's a containment leak in engineering. If we can't get it sealed, we're going to have a warp core breach.
Ensign Monroe, you're wearing a hazard suit. Get down to engineering and help Alana seal that leak.
Turbolift controls malfunctioning. Initiate vocal command using manual.
Deck 11.
Attempting to compensate with maneuvering thrusters.
Sir, here's the damage control progress for the aft side of the deck.
Good. Who's fixing the data shunt here?
Get this containment field down.
There's an override in the Jeffries tube just down that corridor.
Material detected.
Oh. Monroe, what took you so long? We've got a warp core breach in progress. You need to get in there and shut it down. There are two things you have to do, so listen carefully. First, cut the power relays on the main floor. Then go to the upper level and decouple the dilithium matrix. Wait a minute. You're going to need a helmet to get through that coolant leak.
I've got one in my transporter buffer.
Hurry up and find those terminals. There isn't much time before we lose containment and have to reject the core.
Hurry, Monroe. I'm not sure how much time you've got left.
Attention. Warp core breach imminent. Access denied.
Monroe, I just remembered. You're going to need the access code to cut the power relays. Go to the access code station.
Must be cut in order to decouple the dilithium matrix. Displaying power relay access.
Got it.
Cut in order to decouple the dilithium matrix. Attention, this lift has malfunctioned. Access granted. Power relay has been cut. Attention. Warp core breach in 30 seconds. Dilithium matrix decoupled. Warp core offline. Core breach averted.
Good job, Ensign. That was touch and go there for a little while.
No problem, Lieutenant.
Okay, let's get a cleanup crew in here. Seal that leak. We need to get main power back online. Vorik, give me a hand with the resonance cascade modulator. Hey, Ensign, are you blind? Or are you trying to sabotage engineering by wasting my... Gina, watch your alignment. That Isodyne array has to be modulated to exactly 4.7 microjoules.
Yes, ma'am.
Intruder alert. All security and hazard team
Ensign
personnel
Staff,
to the loading
is
dock.
Is the coupling matrix back online yet?
Just another couple of minutes, sir.
How's it look, Justin?
Deck 8, loading
Not
dock.
Good. The whole intermix matrix is out of whack.
Engineering to bridge.
Here, Monroe, take this. Come on.
If you need medical attention, just come back here.
Monroe, over here.
Just a moment. You'll be fine.
We're being invaded by some kind of pirates. They're taking our supplies. We have to stop them. There are two of them behind a barricade in there. They're launching energy grenades. See if you can eliminate them. Ready?
Over here.
Tuvok to Foster. We're pinned down in Cargo Bay 1. We require your immediate assistance.
Monroe, Tuvok needs help. Come with me.
I am certain that many of you are curious as to our situation. Voyager has been transported to a region of space we are not familiar with. It seems that many other disabled vessels are present here as well. We have detected an energy dampening field surrounding the area that is draining Voyager systems of power. For the moment, we are trapped like the other ships and cannot escape.
Like the Tarkanis gravity well, 247 ships have been lost there.
Or the Bermuda Triangle, back on Earth.
Perhaps. Our primary weapons and propulsion systems are offline at the moment. The captain's current strategy is to find out as much as we can about our surroundings while we effect repairs.
So, what's the deal with our unwelcome visitors?
We do not have much information about them as of yet, Mr. Beesman. They appear to be scavengers of some sort, comprised of Klingons, humans, and Malons. With only short-range sensors operational, we have been unable to locate their vessel since it departed. However, we have detected a vessel nearby. While sensors indicate no life signs, we have detected a functioning power source on board. Our hope is that their computer systems are still operational and contain information about this area. The hazard team will transport onto this vessel and retrieve any files that are still intact.
No life signs?
Like a ghost ship.
Yeah.
Boom!
While your superstitious beliefs are quite illogical, Mr. Chell, caution is recommended. Your team leader, Lieutenant Foster, will now brief you on your specific mission objectives. Lieutenant?
All right. This is an information-gathering mission. Minimal encounter probability. The hazard team will split up into two squads. Alpha Squad, my group, will beam into Control Room A. Ensign Monroe and Beta Squad will be transported to Control Room B. Our objective is to have at least one of the teams locate a functioning terminal to extract any information we can and return to Voyager. In the unlikely case of hostile encounters, the technicians should be protected at all costs to ensure retrieval of this information. Any questions?
Sounds like a cakewalk.
See the quartermaster, Oviedo, in the equipment room. Gear up, then report to Transporter Room 1. Dismissed.
Hoping for some action our first time out.
He
careful what you wish for. You just might get it.
To survive this long. I wonder where their ship is.
Austin?
I don't know, Alex. Bad feeling about this.
Hey.
I sure hope they're right about that ship being abandoned.
Telsia.
Hey, Alex. Nervous about the mission? We'll do fine, I'm sure.
Watch it.
Sir.
Yes, Ensign.
Excuse me.
What is it, Ensign?
Got an away mission to perform.
Man, I can't believe I'm getting left behind on our first mission. And an intelligence gathering mission, too.
Hey, relax, Ken. There'll be plenty of other missions.
Yeah, Ken. They're just saving the best for last.
Ms. Durant, while we have some extra time, I thought we'd review first aid combat protocols one more time.
Thank you, Doctor, but I think I am well prepared. I did go through extensive training and testing for this position.
Of course. Well, let me know if you develop any nervousness or pre-mission jitters.
Don't worry, Doctor. You'll be fine.
Doctor.
Don't you have something to shoot at?
Gerard!
I must say I was surprised that I was not selected for this mission. I know the ship is supposed to be deserted. I just hope they don't end up needing a medic.
Ready to transport Team 2.
Energize.
Consoles are working.
Look at this. I've never seen such a ship.
It's almost like it's alive.
Into a data terminal here and started the download.
Chell found one here too. He's accessing it now.
This thing's shields. We can't contact Voyager and we can't beam out. We need to regroup. We've done some scans and it looks like there's a junction point in Section 29.
I see it.
We'll meet up there and figure out how to take these shields down. Good luck. Foster out.
Section 29 is through that door up there.
Great. How do we get up there?
This way.
Thank you. It's open. Right place?
Positive. Maybe the aliens got them.
Boom!
Looks like our scans weren't quite thorough enough.
Hey, Chell! I'm gonna jump! Catch me!
Stow it, crewman. Look, Monroe, we've got to deactivate the shields before we can beam out. The data we downloaded from our console indicated there are three main sources we need to hit in order to do this. Your team should be able to take out the main computer core through there. We'll take out the backup power systems up here. We'll meet up at the main power core and shut it down.
Yes, sir.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's go.
Good luck, Monroe. We'll meet you at the power core.
Hey, Chell, behind you!
Watch it.
another one of those transporters, but it looks like it's deactivated.
Those might be the controls up there. Like another of those transporters over there.
All right, let's go.
Ah! Telsia!
No. What happened? She just disappeared.
Some kind of energy field from that pod.
There's no trace of Telsia. It's as if she was completely vaporized.
There was nothing we could have done, Chell. We better get a move on, or we might be next.
Thank you. down the computer core. I'll work on getting this access door open.
Monroe to Foster. We've shut down the main computer core.
Good. We just shut down the backup power systems. We're on our way to the main power core.
Right. Chell and I will meet you there.
You and... where's Telsia?
She didn't make it.
Understood. We'll be in the back.
Heads up!
Keep it together, Chell. It's just you and me now, and Voyager's depending on us to get this information back to them. If we fail, everyone on that ship could end up dead. Now let's go shut down that power core and get out of here.
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir.
We'll make it, Chell. We have to. Come on.
Some of those fireflies in here to fix this thing. Stay open as if one of us keeps it open from here. I guess that means me, huh?
Don't worry, Chell. We're almost out of here.
Okay, but hurry.
He's okay. What happened to your team? I thought you were all killed.
Those alien things overwhelmed us, but I managed to get away. Now we've got to move on if we're going to salvage this mission at all. System. What the? It's Tensia. And Beesman. They're all here. They're breathing. They must still be alive. Maybe they're being kept for food.
We've got to get them out of there.
Right. We just have to shut down the power core. Then we can beam them all out of here. Maybe the doctor can do something for them if it's not too late. Come on.
Trying to communicate. capture your people and analyze them. Learn the language of men, of Ethereans. I've been trapped here 25 of your Sol standard years. Crew, very large. Colony ship. Our people in stasis stay alive.
Colony ship?
Must be a sleeper ship for long voyages.
Yes, long journey. New home. Never will see it now, the fear. The Forge has us. No escape.
We're sorry for the misunderstanding. For killing some of your people. We were only acting in self-defense.
Kill? Have not killed. When injured, our people return to stasis. Regenerated. Your people too, not killed. In stasis. Analyzed.
Those pods.
On behalf of my people, I apologize. We thought the vessel was abandoned. We only wanted information from your computer. We're trying to find our way out of here.
Our knowledge is yours. Request and receive. We are allies. We will lower defenses. You may return to your vessel.
Find a way out. You'll get to your new home.
Foster to Voyager.
Lieutenant, it's good to hear your voice. What happened over there?
I'll explain when we get back. Let's just say we've made an ally. But we have injuries. We need to beam directly to signal.
Stand by. Sickbay has the wounded. We're ready to beam you back now.
Acknowledged. Foster out. It looked pretty bad out there for a while, but we got the job done. Have the doctor look at you and then join me in Hazard Ops. I'll be assembling the rest of the team for debriefing.
Yes, sir.
I don't care if your hemorrhoids are chronic. There are no medical deferments.
Took a little beating over there. Hey, Doc, want to take a look at Monroe?
Doctor?
Ah, Miss Monroe. Your injuries seem to be rather superficial. Dermal regeneration will not be necessary. Though you have some mild skin irritation, perhaps you would like an analgesic cream?
Whatever.
Scans indicate a possible neck injury.
Out of my way.
Excuse me.
Sorry, I don't have time for chit-chat.
Deck 4, hazard operations.
You think you had it tough? Try being a Betazoid on Vulcan, where any hint of emotion is frowned upon.
Hey, Alex.
Just come from sickbay?
So, how's the Oralite cobbler?
Delicious, thank you.
Mr. Chang, your carnelian stew?
Great, thanks.
You know, you really didn't have to hand-make all this for us.
Well, just because you're on duty doesn't mean you should be forced to eat replicator rations.
Thank you, Neelix.
Neelix?
I'll be with you in a minute, Ensign.
Pretty good.
Well, that's not really fair. We didn't know what to expect. We didn't have all the information.
Hey, Monroe.
Alex, did you hear anything about where they're sending us next?
I heard Chakotay and Tuvok talking about the scavengers.
Oh, yeah?
I ran into Kim. He was going over the data we brought back. He says they had some data on that machine that brought us here.
Hey, Monroe. Word has it I'll be coming along in the next mission. Some kind of stealth operation?
All available hazard team personnel report to the briefing room.
With the information your team retrieved, we've been able to learn a few things about our situation. This is called the Forge. It's generating the dappening field that keeps Voyager and the other ships trapped here.
Do we have any idea what's running that thing? Or why it's here?
No. The Aetherians had no detailed information about it. For all we know, it could be a simple machine. But our main concern right now is finding a way out of here. This is isodesium, a rare isotope that doesn't seem to be affected by the dampening field. B'Elanna thinks she can use it to get repairs done and bring main power back online. Then, hopefully, Voyager can escape. The sensor info from the Aetherians shows that there is isodesium nearby. Unfortunately, it's located here.
What is that?
The scavenger's base of operations. These are the scavengers, a loose alliance of survivors from the other starships trapped here. They survive by raiding other ships for supplies, like their attack on Voyager earlier. The isodesium was most likely stolen from other ships. Looks like they used some of it, but most of it is scattered around their base. They probably don't know of its energy potential. It's imperative that we get the isodesium and get Voyager functioning again. We don't know what other surprises we'll encounter here or what that forge has in store for us.
Sensors show hundreds of scavengers on that base. All races we're familiar with. Klingon, human, Melon, and Hirogen. We're a bit outnumbered here, so we've opted for stealth infiltration and retrieval operation. They seem to have a transporter inhibitor field, so a team of five will be shuttled to the base by Ensign Paris. Once there, Ken and I will set up an extraction point. Monroe, Telsia, and Odell will split up and retrieve three samples of the isodesium each. When you're done, you will make your way back to the extraction point. That's it, people. Now get prepped and report to the shuttle bay.
Good luck, team.
Serious, man. Vulcans love it when you yank real hard on their ears. Some Vulcan pain ritual thing.
Really?
Yeah. How do you think they got so pointy? Trust me. Try it. Tuvok will have an all-new respect for you.
I don't know.
sounds like a von Neumann machine. Automated self-replicating probes. Rigelians had something similar. They'd land on a planet and use local resources to build more probes and send them out.
That is so they would multiply exponentially. There could be billions of these forges all over the galaxy.
You better get equipped and get down to the shuttle bay. Foster's waiting.
Good luck, Monroe.
Good work, Wire. Take this to the captain.
Yes, sir.
Monroe, good luck on the mission.
Thank you, sir.
We just finished replicating the new compound grenade rifle. I know it's a stealth mission, but you never know what you're going to run into out there. Can't hurt to be prepared. The primary trigger launches a taser grenade, and the secondary launches magnetic charges. You might want to test it out on the holodeck here first.
See much action?
Yeah, we must be the second string hazard team.
Fine by me. Who knows what they'll find over there?
We handled those scavengers pretty well last time. I'm sure they won't have any problems.
But on the bright side, I should be really good at poker by the time we get back to Earth.
Deck 10, Shuttle Bay.
Hey, Monroe, they're waiting for you down below. They're having some trouble with the docking clamps, but I think Salmon Lang are on it.
I'd guess.
Yeah, I thought I saw a Kavort-class bird of prey in there.
Yeah, Klingons.
Yeah, what's with that anyway? I mean, are we allies with the Klingons?
I heard Chakotay saying they didn't answer hails, but maybe they have no comm system. Anyway, they attacked us, so they must be hostile.
Yeah, and who knows how long they've been here? They might not even know we're allies.
Right.
We don't want to activate the pattern enhancers until we're ready to beam out.
Gotcha. We don't want anyone detecting us too soon.
I'll try it again.
I've already tried it 5 times. They're stuck. The controls must have been damaged in the attack.
Not
Great.
Lang to Paris. I'm down below, but there's a serious exhaust leak down here. I can't get to the overrides.
Hey, Les. Can you send one of your men down there? If we can't get those docking clamps released, we'll be going nowhere fast.
Sure. Monroe, you don't look busy. Get down below and see what you can do.
We tried that. It's sealed from the inside. You'll have to go around.
Seroton gas. It's got to be over 500 degrees. I don't think even your hazard suit can protect you from that kind of gas. Seroton gas. It's got to be over 500 degrees. I don't think even your hazard suit can protect you from that kind of gas.
Show on the road.
Tom Paris at your service. I will be your captain for this flight. I estimate a cruising speed of about 2/3 impulse power and an elapsed time of just under 5 minutes.
All right, Captain. We're all set here.
Okay, all aboard. This is your captain speaking. The in-flight movie will be Captain Proton versus the Robo-Zombies. Thank you for flying Delta Flyer Airlines, and we hope you have a pleasant flight.
Two.
Kelsia checking in. I'm in position.
Odell checking in. I'm through the third airlock.
All right, team. We'll be using a coded Federation subspace comm channel, but try to maintain comm silence unless absolutely necessary. When I give the signal, return here. We'll have pattern enhancers set up to beam us out.
Okay, Monroe. We'll be able to track you for a little while here. We'll try to alert you to any dangers we can detect. Careful. No running. Footsteps could alert the Klingons. Stay quiet. Signs just ahead. Lean around the corner and check it out. Supposed to avoid detection.
Sorry, sir.
Just get the isodesium and get back here.
Odell checking in, sir.
Go ahead.
I found some isodesium. This section looks Malon in design. Run down, lots of fog. Radiation levels are high.
Roger. Foster out.
Filthy creature!
Yeah.
checking in, sir.
Go ahead.
I found a sample of the isodesium. Sir, this area looks like a Federation ship, early 23rd century. But I don't recognize these markings.
This is not an archaeological expedition. Just get the samples and get out.
Roger, sir. Telsia out.
What's your status?
I just found my first sample, sir.
Roger. Foster out.
I'm being followed. I'll check in later. Odell out.
Here.
I need a diversion. This area is heavily guarded. Can you transfer far away from this quadrant?
You're in the Klingon engineering section. There should be a power transfer console on top level.
What does it look like?
You'll know it when you see it.
Okay.
Oh.
Monroe.
Saboteurs. What? Why did you divert our power?
We did not!
Our whole section is on emergency life.
Bah! So much the better. Now you won't have to see each other.
Cover me!
Monroe to Foster. I have the last sample of isodesium. I'm on my way back.
Hold on, Monroe. Odell hasn't reported back yet. We can't get any response from him. Can you go check it out?
Yeah. I'm right by the entrance to the Malon area.
Good. See if you can find Odell. But be careful. Foster out.
Monroe to Ken. There's a security door at the Malon entrance.
Roger. I'll see if I can override it from here.
Where is the Alpha?
He's on a hunt. Some fresh prey, I hear.
Odell.
Yes, sir. I was ambushed. A weapon. Communicator. Taken. Never saw them.
Save your strength, Tom. I'll beam you out of here. Monroe to Foster. I found Odell. He's hurt bad. I'm beaming him back to the extraction point with his isodesium.
Understood. Foster out.
Monroe. Wait. I still have to get one more sample of the isodesium.
Don't worry, Tom. I'll get it.
Be careful. Ambush.
Monroe to Foster. I found the last piece of isodesium. There's a huge bay between us. There's a crane system of some sort, but the control room is on the other side.
Wait a second, Alex. I think I know where you are. I was just there. Hold on.
Okay, I'm here. I see the controls. Give me just a second.
Telsia, behind you!
Take her alive!
What's going on down there?
Telsia's been captured. I've got to rescue her.
Of all the... All right, Monroe, but be careful. We can't afford to lose another man. If you can't rescue her, just get back here.
Don't worry, sir. I'll get her. Monroe out.
Thank you.
like the Malons would come back after what we did to them the last time.
Is being held, but this area is swarming with scavengers. It's going to be impossible for me to get to her.
Don't risk the mission, Monroe. If the odds are overwhelming, you're going to have to abort. Telsia knew what she was getting into. She wouldn't want you to get killed in some hopeless...
Wait a second. I've got an idea. Monroe out.
Get me some Veritrax 12 from the lab. It's the blue hypo spray.
Hit the alarm!
arm.
Restraints. The only way back to the extraction point is through the control center, and it's sure to be guarded.
All right. Then you'll have to pretend to be my prisoner.
Oh, come on, Monroe. That's the oldest one in the book.
Any better suggestions?
Okay, okay. Here,
follow me.
Passcode for the door. Give me a second.
Four of them. Be ready.
Is going to work this time.
It didn't work the first time.
I told you that was the oldest one in the book.
Is that the only way back?
The one and only.
Okay, look, I've got an idea. I'll go out there and distract them. They shouldn't recognize me with this disguise on. At least, not right away. While they're distracted, you sneak out. Take all the isodesium with you.
But what if they realize you're not one of them? Are you sure that...
I'll be fine. Trust me.
Hey, Monroe. Last one, there's a Denebian slime devil.
Hey, what are you doing here?
The captain sent me down to check things out.
Really? I didn't hear anything from the captain about this.
Oh, yeah. The communications are out. He sent me down here to tell you in person.
Tell us what?
That I'm coming?
I don't think I've seen you before.
Who?
All hands, red alert. There's an intruder disguised as one of us with a woman. They killed the captain. Capture them at all costs.
Kill her!
Wait a second.
I have been tracking you since you entered our hunting grounds.
You are not the most formidable prey I've had, but you shall do.
Look, there's no need for this. Can't we just...
The most formidable prey I've had. But you shall do.
Look, there's no need for this. Can't we just...
Your skull shall make an excellent trophy for my wall.
Since you entered our hunting grounds, you are not the most formidable prey I've had, but you shall do.
Look, there's no need for this. Can't we just...